Hi, this is Taylor Taranto of EOR News, and this is End of the Road Outro. And I've been, since shutting down the project, and trust me, it is shut down. There really is nothing left to report. I know there's a whole bunch of stuff, blah, 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 this thing, that thing. Trump is appointing a cabinet, blah, 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 blah. I don't care. Nothing's changed. Actually, something did change, but it has nothing to do with the news. It has something to do with the channel. And, but first, I want to talk about, this early retirement phase and this home stretch kind of final, moments. And I have been looking for a job, and I'm doing chief negotiation efforts with a lot of people. Boy, it's been getting really nuts over here. Oh man, all the offers. So first things first, I'm going to give you an update about what has been going on. It's been kind of quiet. My roommate, Edward Kelly, read his verdict. That's official now. He should be going to Tennessee, where his family is. He's going to have another trial of some sort in Tennessee for the conspiracy of killing or trying to kill an FBI agent or agents. You can read about some of that. There's more coming on that stuff. So it's really, really, really good to read as much as you can instead of listening to the pundits out there who are trying to get you to think one way or another. So, also, I have two new lawyers appointed over my case. You can read about that in the court filings. I'm not going to say who. If you're really interested, you can look for yourself. And it's kind of funny, too, because it's the lawyer who Jake Lang and his cohorts have been pushing on me. And I hear they're really great for January Sixers, so we'll see what happens. The other funny part about that is that they have not given me any money for the month. So, yeah, I know they said they were. They publicly said that, and I haven't seen it. So, it's been a while now. I don't really know what they're up to, but I can only sense that it's no good. Jake Lang has been on MSNBC getting many coverage all over the place for his comments after Trump was elected the president. And he's saying things that are kind of dubious, and the media's been covering it as a reason to attack President Trump, saying, yeah, Trump is going to pardon all these violent people. And, the thing is, Jake Lang doesn't know. No one really knows how many people at January 6th are going to get pardoned. It's kind of foolish to think that Trump would pardon a bunch of people that the media is using to attack him. But who knows? We'll see who he appoints into these positions. And hopefully he takes some good advice from someone out there who knows everything there is about the January 6th stuff. It isn't just some sort of, political hack or washed up loser. Anyways, so that's mostly what I have to say. I have an update about this Alicia Powell stuff, because it is really strange. So I'm going to get you kind of remembering some of this stuff. Remember, when Ryan Stancil showed up, I could immediately see through what this guy was up to. He runs in a really weird circle. Alicia Powell, Gateway Pundit people, that run the company, the higher ups. What was his name? Patrick Byrne. I supposedly reached out and tried to give this guy money, or did give him money or something. Jake Lang, you heard what he had to say about Jake. And you heard what he had to say about Alicia. So it's kind of sketchy all around because he runs with these people. And I don't know what they're up to. And I don't believe anything he was really saying. But I do have some observations. And I told everyone to think with their own thinking caps and not just to listen to my opinions and not just to listen to, Ryan. So, and to do their own digging and figure it out for themselves, because it doesn't really matter. I have an audience of like 20-some people, and there's no way these people are this stupid. But here, let's just read it out loud, because the idea was, I thought, and I'm pretty sure, that they were trying to do a discrediting campaign on everything that I've uncovered and discourage anyone from actually listening to this stuff. And I don't think it's going to work, but let's just go ahead and go through it. The idea was Ashley Babbitt is an FBI agent. Plus. Let's see here, what else? Then there was the whole guy that tried to get me to riot. We did that. That was Jaden X, John Sullivan, Antifa, BLM, DOJ. I mean, he said a lot of stuff. He also said CIA. So, I mean, we're going to tie some of this stuff together. Real interesting. I haven't reported this, but I'm going to. You'll see where I'm coming from with this stuff. The CIA, that's this really big story I'm working on, and their ties to the January 6th stuff. And that seems to be where all of this stuff, this momentum is really building up, and there's going to be a huge drop. You know, we were calling it the October surprise. It's been pushed out because we could just see that Trump was going to win. And so I'm not affiliated with Trump or his campaign in any way, but I could see that this was all going to go a certain way, and it just seems so obvious. I mean, you remember my election night reporting. It was really fast, and it was before anyone even did anything. I called it. I said Trump was going to win by a lot. In fact, my roommate heard the rest of it where I said, basically, it's going to be about by the end of the night, because we're going to bed, and usually they rig it in the middle of the night, and I said, yeah, he's going to have, if everything continues, which is the route it's going, he's going to be up 100. So right now he's about 100 over that, his competition there, Kamala Harris. And it seems like my reporting and my statistical analysis was spot on. It's too bad I didn't have time to do more recordings that night. My helper had to leave, and so I couldn't do these recordings. So I got it all out as fast as possible. So we're going to go back to October 19th, around the time that I did an interview with Ryan Samsel. All right, so this was kind of the back and forth that I had. Remember, this is all October 19th. Alicia Powe says she didn't block Ryan Samsel. Ryan came up to me and said, she blocked me. All right. But then she said to me that she didn't, and to tell him that she didn't, and blah, 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 who cares, drama. She says she can't wait for all of this toxic stuff to be over. She said toxic. And that Trump had already won. She helped tell Ryan Samsel's story as much as possible. I asked her if she helps all other J6ers with legal fundraising, and how much she has raised for Ryan specifically. Then she ignores me, okay? So we got all caught up. Then that's when Ryan and I do the interview where he spills the beans. So that's kind of interesting stuff. Now, this was just, let's see here. I'm trying to see what day it is. So this was just, I guess November 8th at 6:44 p.m. She reaches out to chastise me for the interview with Ryan. I suspect, I don't really understand what she's getting at. He writes, what's your problem? This is a quote. Quote, what's your problem? You don't even know me or a thing about me. Well, it's not true, but which I know a lot about her. And Ryan insists that he has told me much more. Whether I can believe it, that's different. So I have assisted dozens of J6ers and haven't earned an extra dollar for this sacrifice. Okay, we're gonna punch through this and criticize as we go. No one pays me even text you here. And I see your blog nonsense about how I'm grifting money. Okay. I single-handedly assisted Ryan with a lawsuit for his medical for free over a year. Maybe you should learn facts before you go on spreading lies. You J6ers really are a bunch of low-lives losers. Most of you anyway, end quote. Okay, so that was that was yesterday night. Wow, right? That's really interesting stuff. So this is the person that's dedicated all this time, and this is what she really thinks of the people that she's working for. Free of charge, she says in this message. All right, so I wrote back to her that Ryan showed me his messages between them and that I gave her weeks to respond. Okay, so that's all true. And I'm not going to go over all the messages he said because I think somebody's listening. It shows that she's actually listening. She pretends that she doesn't, and I know that she pretends, but she can't have it both ways when she says some of this stuff. All right, so anyways, let's see here. I gave her weeks to respond, and she, of all people, should realize anyone, including J6ers, have First Amendment rights to publish, and she doesn't have a monopoly or immunity from publishing one way, and as in, like, she gets to determine the outcome of all news. She's the news arbiter of truth or something. And then I told her Trump won, which I thought was strange because, you know, if we're all in the same boat, she shouldn't have a problem with this stuff. Anyways, it seems that all this is really radically different. You know, there's a lot of truth from fiction to separate out here.
You have one minute remaining.
Let's just go back with the whole she blocked Ryan Samsel and then she said she didn't to me personally. So that's really weird. Now, we're going to have to do a part two of this. This is probably going to be, this outro is probably going to be parted many times over, and I'm probably going to forget the count, but every episode from this point forward is going to be an outro. It's not really reporting the news so much. It's really life as is in here for me. This was supposed to be, or it still is, I suppose, kind of an informative historical account of what happened in here. You can follow this news. We go through all of it. You can go back and piece it together through times and dates. And you can be an expert. You can be an expert more than me if you study this stuff, because I'm trying to forget it. This stuff is crazy. But we're going to see some more crazy stuff as this goes along. So get ready, please.
Thank you for using Global Tel Link.